Hello everyone, let's dive into some royal news that's been making waves recently. It's about Meghan Markle and the subtle yet significant message sent her way by King Charles. It's hard to fathom what goes on in Meghan's mind, and frankly, it's a bit of a mystery. But what's intriguing is her perception of her place in Harry's family. Does Meghan sense their apparent disdain, or does she hold on to the belief that they're just envious and awaiting a moment of reconciliation? This week, King Charles made a move that speaks volumes. With a single line, he seemed to underline his view of Meghan's place in the royal family. Meghan's understanding of family dynamics has always been a topic of debate, considering the rifts in her own family and the one she's seemingly influenced Harry to create in his. The incident in question happened during King Charles's state visit to Kenya with Queen Camilla. This trip marks their first official visit since he became king in September 2022. At a state banquet, King Charles shared a touching story about Kenya's significance to his family. He reminisced about his son, the Prince of Wales, proposing to my beloved daughter-in-law in view of Mount Kenya back in 2010. It's important to note his choice of words. He didn't generalize about his sons or daughters-in-law. He specifically mentioned my son, the Prince of Wales, and my beloved daughter-in-law. It's clear that King Charles is very deliberate with his words, showcasing a depth of affection and recognition for some family members, perhaps hinting at a contrast with others. In royal circles, a word is often more than just a word, especially when it comes from King Charles. Known for his precision in language, his recent comments have sparked discussions about what's left unsaid, particularly regarding Meghan and Harry. It seems there's a subtle message being sent their way, and it's not exactly a warm one. But that's not all. The King's commitment to sustainability, especially evident during his recent trip to Kenya, throws a stark light on Harry and Meghan's choices. King Charles and Queen Camilla's journey on the RAF Voyager, notably fueled with 40% sustainable aviation fuel, stands in contrast to the Duke and Duchess of Sussex's preference for private jets. This was highlighted by Cameron Walker, a royal correspondent for GB News, who noted the royal couple's environmentally conscious travel arrangements. The difference is stark when you look at Harry and Meghan's recent travel itinerary. Their trip from New Jersey to Canaan, followed by a flight to Atlanta, was all done via private jet. This raises questions about their commitment to sustainability, especially in light of their public stance on environmental issues. King Charles, on the other hand, has a long-standing record of environmental advocacy. As far back as 1970, he voiced concerns about pollution and its effects. More recently, in 2021, he expressed understanding for environmental groups like Extinction Rebellion and Insulate Britain, though he critiqued their methods in a BBC interview. When it comes to environmental stewardship, it seems King Charles walks the talk, setting an example that raises questions about the actions of others in the royal family. In the realm of royal environmental activism, King Charles stands as a notable figure, deeply committed to the cause. His actions contrast sharply with those of Meghan and Harry, whose environmental concerns seem to take a backseat to their lifestyle choices. Once, I believed Harry shared his brother William's and his father's dedication to environmental issues. William's Earthshot Prize and King Charles's efforts to minimize his carbon footprint highlight a family legacy of environmental consciousness, a legacy Harry seems to have stepped away from. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex's frequent use of private jets raises eyebrows, especially given their expressed concerns for the planet. Harry's justification of needing to protect his family doesn't quite align with the lack of sustainable options in their travel choices. If safety is the priority, why not couple it with environmental responsibility? Their financial resources surely allow for more sustainable travel options. Moreover, their travel seems to lack real purpose, leading to questions about their motives. Why the need for these trips that resemble royal tours, especially when their royal status is no longer active? It appears they are more focused on maintaining their public image than on environmental concerns. As royal commentator Esther Krakus pointed out, Harry and Meghan's life since leaving the royal family has been a mix of seeking privacy and simultaneously making high-profile deals with companies like Netflix and Spotify. This paradoxical approach has drawn comparisons to celebrities like the Kardashians, known for being in the limelight for the sake of fame itself. Harry and Meghan's actions, from their departure from royal duties to their media engagements, seem to perpetuate this cycle of attention and controversy, distancing them further from the more traditional and environmentally conscious approach of the royal family. In the ever-evolving narrative of the royal family, Harry and Meghan continue to provide ample fodder for satire, often finding themselves at the center of public scrutiny for their actions, or lack thereof. Their recent venture into podcasting with Spotify, which reportedly ended due to mismatched expectations, only reinforced perceptions that they might not have much to contribute in terms of substantial content. Turning to the critical issue of climate change, a topic that demands serious attention, Harry and Meghan's approach seems to fall short. For public figures who have expressed a desire to inspire and lead, their actions often contradict their words. This disparity between what they say and what they do when it comes to environmental responsibility has not gone unnoticed, possibly even within the royal family itself. The message is clear: to truly make an impact, one must lead by example, something that Harry, with his upbringing, is more than capable of. In a lighter vein, social media has been abuzz with a curious photo purportedly showing Harry and Meghan trick-or-treating with their children. However, the photo's authenticity is questionable, with faces hardly recognizable, leading to speculation about who's actually in the picture. This incident, like many others, seems to echo a pattern in Harry and Meghan's public life, a constant need to vie for attention, especially when overshadowed by other members of the royal family. Their actions often seem to be a reaction to events in the royal sphere, as they strive to maintain their relevance in the public eye. In a curious twist in the saga of Harry and Meghan's life in California, a photo has surfaced on an Instagram account by the name of Margot Combra. The origins and authenticity of this photo are shrouded in mystery. There's speculation that this could be a tactical move by Meghan and Harry's PR team, a strategy of releasing information through seemingly unconnected sources to maintain a degree of plausible deniability in their ongoing media narrative with the royal family. The photo itself raises more questions than it answers. One noticeable detail is the lack of costumes for the children, a peculiar omission if they were indeed out trick-or-treating. The identity of the individuals in the picture, especially the children, is also dubious. One can barely discern more than a foot and some pink fabric, which does little to confirm the identity of the child being referred to as Invisibet. The woman assumed to be Meghan in the photo also doesn't quite convince. This tactic, if indeed orchestrated by Meghan and Harry, seems to be part of a larger strategy to maintain visibility and relevance, perhaps as a counter to their perceived marginalization by the royal family. The effectiveness and intent behind such moves are a matter of debate and speculation among followers of royal news. As the story develops and this photo possibly gains traction in the media, it will be interesting to see how it plays into the ongoing narrative surrounding the Duke and Duchess of Sussex. As we wrap up this discussion on the latest developments in the lives of Harry and Meghan, it's clear that their actions continue to stir interest and debate. The mysterious photo on Margot Combra's Instagram is just the latest chapter in their ongoing narrative. It leaves us with more questions than answers, particularly about the authenticity of the image and the identities of those pictured. This intriguing development is part of the larger, complex story of the Duke and Duchess of Sussex. Their every move, whether directly or indirectly, seems to catch the public's eye and fuels ongoing conversations about their place in the royal landscape and beyond. We'll be keeping an eye on how this story unfolds, especially if the photo gains wider attention in the media. It's a situation that undoubtedly will continue to evolve, providing more material for discussion and analysis.